What's up, YouTube? This is DEFCON 3 Security coming at you from somewhere here. Actually, I'm in front of my house. I'm in my driveway. So this is a record for me, 3 videos in one day. Usually I like to keep it at the most 2 videos, but I do have a new subscriber and I want to help him out. And he's got a really good question. His question is, when you try to get your firearm permit, right, you have to take a psychological exam. At least I know in California, as of last year, July, before they give you the actual card that says, hey, you can start carrying a firearm, you have to take a psychological exam. And the thing is, and he makes a point, there's like no information out there about what the test is like, what to expect. So I imagine he wants to do it ASAP, so I'm gonna make this video for him just to, you know, I know he's pressed for time. So let's get this video knocked out. All right, so after you go to the firing range, right, you take your test and all that, you're gonna do your background check, you can do like a federal or state or some sort of FBI check. It's a little bit more extensive when you try to get your firearm permit, right? You're gonna do some couple background checks. A few months will go by. And after a few months, because there's a big backlog, after a few months, you're gonna get some letter in the mail. And it's gonna say, hey, you are on your way to getting your firearm permit. We just need you to take a psychological exam. I think it was either $100 or $200. And then anyways, it says, here's a bunch of locations you can go to, choose one, and you'll get your result in 10 days. So once you take your psych exam, you will see your results in 10 days, and then I guess they'll automatically matriculate that information to the BSIS, so you don't have to send anything in the mail, they'll do it for you, and then in 10 days you'll get your you'll get your results. And then a couple days later, I got my actual card that says, hey, you can start carrying a firearm. So this is, gosh, man, I got something in my eye again, or allergies. So this is how it works. And I don't want to, here's the thing, guys, it's really important, this psych exam. I am not going to give you any answers to the test. If I give you some test questions, these are things that I made up. I mean, the last thing I want is somebody that cannot pass the psych exam to pass it because I gave them the answers. If you're meant to fail that, it's because you should not be carrying a firearm, okay? I mean, you get where I'm coming from. But I'll give you some idea of what the test is like so that you're not intimidated about it, because I was freaked out, man. Before I took the test, I'm like, oh my God, they're going to have me talk to a psychologist and he's gonna start asking me, you know, tell me about your mom and dad, questions like that. So I didn't know what to expect, and it made me really nervous. But that's not at all how it happened. So I'll give you the basics of what it's like, but I'm not gonna give you any answers. Just like I wouldn't wanna give you answers to your driving test for the DMV, because if you can't pass that test, you probably shouldn't be on the road. All right, fair enough? All right, so. I get the paper and it says choose a location that's near you and convenient. So I called a few places and one guy goes, oh, we have a test 2 weeks from now. Another guy says, oh, we have a test a month from now. So I drove a little bit further so I can get a test in 3 days, so I don't have to wait a month or two, because, man, I was dying to start making that extra money carrying my firearm. So the sooner I get that done, the better. So I ended up taking a test in this place in Hayward, California. I show up to the facility and, man, they are strict. No joke, bro. When I go there, they're like, do you have your paperwork? If you don't have your paperwork, the invitation that they sent you, that's it, you're done. It's just that simple. So make sure, and the paperwork will tell you on there, it'll say in big letters, bring this to the testing site or you will be disqualified, something like that, right? So bring the paperwork. It will literally tell you on there, do not bring your phone, do not have a watch on, do not have any sort of recording equipment. I think they don't even want you to bring your own pen, believe it or not. They'll give you all that stuff. When I got there, they were like, "All right, put this in your locker, put that." So they gave me a key, right? They checked me in. I gave them the paperwork. They're like, "Have a seat." And there's a big sign that says no talking at all. And I'm thinking, man, why so strict? I think that's part of the test. I literally think that they want to see your temperament. If you flip out, you know, over all these rules, maybe you shouldn't be carrying a gun. So there's a sign that says no talking, no eating, no coffee, no you name it, right? Then they had me sit down. 10 minutes later, they like had me come up to the desk and they were like, "You have your watch on. Can you put that in a locker?" And they gave me some keys. I went to the locker and then I put that in there and then I had to give them the key back or something. And then they're like, "All right, so let me log you in." They started asking me some basic information. They wanted to see my driver's license, maybe something else. I don't know. Maybe a copy of something. I could have swore they wanted something else, but it would be on that little paper, the requirements, once you get it. Then they says, "All right, let's walk you to the back." And I walk into a room and there's a bunch of computers. There's no psychologists, there's no people. There's literally a bunch of computers and people are taking tests on the computer. That's your psychological exam. It's multiple choice. It's just basically, I think, 100 questions roughly. And you'll start finding that these questions start to repeat themselves after a while. Now, again, I'm not going to give you any of the test questions, but I'll give you an idea of what it could be like, right? So it might ask you something like, "Would you rather be an artist or would you rather play for the NBA? And you're like, "Wait, what? A or B? Maybe, I don't know. I'd rather play for the NBA. My guess is an artist likes to work alone, whereas an NBA player likes to work as a team. So maybe the ideal candidate would be a team player versus somebody that likes to be recluse on their own painting. Or it could be vice versa. Maybe they would have rather me put, I'd rather be an artist because it shows that I'm patient, that I can work by myself. Whereas an NBA player, you have to be with people all the time, right?" There might be a few questions in there that says something like, "Have you ever thought of killing somebody or killing yourself or harming yourself?" Right? So those are obvious questions. But yeah, that's basically the test. It'll just ask you random things like that. Do you like, and again, I'm making up these questions, but I'm keeping it sort of close to what the test is. It might say something like, "Do you enjoy being at parties? Do you enjoy hanging out with people?" Things like that. So really, my advice to you is just answer honestly. If you are a normal, sane person, then you will be just fine. This test is very complicated. It is beyond my scope of understanding humans. They obviously came up with these questions to try to make it fail-proof. You will notice that a lot of questions repeat themselves, but they're worded differently. So don't try to trick the test or answer it how you think they would want you to answer, but rather answer honestly and you should be just fine. Everybody that I have ever known has never failed the test. So it's not really a test per se, but rather just a aptitude test to see if you are capable of handling a firearm. You know, it's a huge responsibility to have a firearm. And again, they just want to make sure that you're not going to harm yourself or somebody else, or just basically to make sure that you're responsible, mature enough to have a firearm. So after I took the test, it says, you know, click here to end the test. I ended the test. Somebody came in there, walked me out of the testing room. And again, I think there was like 30 people testing at that very moment. There was just computers all in a circle. And then somebody walked me out of the room and they says, "Okay, here's the key. Get your stuff out the locker. Thank you very much." I didn't ask them anything like, "Well, how long is this going to take?" Or, you know, "Should I expect the results?" Or, you know, because it made it clear on the paper, you will not get the results. You will get your results within 10 days in the mail. on the very 10th day, I got my results. So they, you know, I was literally like checking my mail and I'm like, damn, dude, it's day number 10, 10 business days. And I haven't gotten my results yet. Mailman came and I'm like, whoa, there you go. So they were right. You get it in 10 days or less. In this case, I got it on the 10th day. And then 3 days later, I got my actual card in a mail that said, hey, you know, it didn't say congratulations, but basically that's what it was. It was like, hey, here's your card. And I went to my boss and say, hey, man, I got my card in the mail. It says I can start carrying a firearm. And they're like, great. And that was that, man. Next day I went to work. They put me on a new site. I had a gun on my side. Man, it was surreal. I couldn't believe I was walking in public with a firearm. And when I say public, I mean on my work site. I wasn't like going to the mall and stuff. That would be highly illegal. But you know, I was literally armed. So there you go, man. I hope that answers your question. I might have missed a few things, but you get the idea. It's not really something you should worry about. It's not something you should study or try to go online and find the answers. Just be yourself. Answer honestly. You should be just fine. And I think they would be able to catch you if you were lying, because some of the questions, you know, they repeat themselves, but they change it just enough. And this test is really old. It's tried and true test made by a panel of psychologists. So if you try to like fake it or anything, it might actually make you look worse than what you really are. Or they might find out that you're actually lying. I don't know. I don't know how the whole dynamics of this test work. I tried to research it, and it's very complicated how they came up with the whole algorithm to make this figure out if you are qualified or not. But just take it, be yourself. All right, guys, I hope that answered your question. If you have any more questions, just ask me in the comments. But I think that should give you some idea. All right, guys, know your worth, know your value, value your time. Above all, be safe.